The chapter of Fatiha starts with Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Taking into consideration the fact that the secrets are being hidden in the bar, a person who starts to do anything with Bismillah, following the Bismillah, a descent is made to the qualities as the meaning of the names Rahman, the Beneficent, and Rahim, the Merciful.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Welcome back to Reflections. We've been talking about this incredible chapter, Surah Al-Fatiha. It's coming to a close, and believe me, we haven't really given it justice. I recorded once in America with a group of students 13 lessons just on Surah Al-Fatiha. We stopped talking at the verse Iyyaka na'budu wa iyyaka nasta'in, and it's beautiful because that verse gives it the concept of ibadah. The word ibadah actually comes from a word which means to pave something smooth. We say tariq ma'bad, a road or way which has been made smooth because so many people have walked over it. Ibadah is a way that we smooth out our hearts and our minds by worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, drawing nearer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, facing all the potholes of life. The spiritual potholes are all smoothed away with the ibadah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam used to say about salah to Bilal radiallahu anhu, arihna biha ya Bilal, which means give us a rest with salah. Give us a rest with salah. How many of us now, we look at salah in a way that it's like a break, like the same type of break we get at school or the same type of break we get at work? This is a break that we take when we pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's interesting also that we talk about ibadah and the rest of the chapter is an explanation of really how to attain the proper characteristics of the worshippers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because the worshippers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have three important characteristics. Number one is they worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. Number two, they worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala according to the way of Islam. And number three, they decorate all of that with the beauty of good character, of good akhlaq. The most honorable position that anyone can hold is to be the servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam said that the most beautiful names, the most beloved names to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Abdullah and Abdurrahman, is the servant of Allah and the servant of Ar-Rahman. And when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took his Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam on the night of Isra wal Mi'raj above the seven heavens, he said, Subhanalladhi asra bi abdihi. He did not say, Subhanalladhi asra bi nabiyihi. He did not say, Subhanalladhi, glorified be the one who caused his Prophet to make Isra. He used the word abd. So Imam Al-Qurtubi rahimahullahu ta'ala said that the closest someone can become to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said that the closest that someone can come to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is by being his servant, by being the servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The rest of the surah is a bayan or tafsir of what it means to be those who na'budullah wa nasta'inu billah, those who worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and those who seek the help of Allah. And the end of the chapter divides humanity into three characteristics. And the ulama said that there's no fourth. No one can escape except being from one of these three. Number one are those people, Allah says about them, اِهْدِنَا الصِّرَاطَ الْمُسْتَقِيمِ صِرَاطَ الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمْتَ عَلَيْهِمْ. After we ask Allah, guide us to the straight path. And maybe Muslims are going to ask, if we're already Muslim, why do we have to ask Allah, اِهْدِنَا, guide us? And here he doesn't say, اِهْدِنِي, guide me, guide us. As Imam Al-Razi said, rahimahullah ta'ala, that hidayah is a gift from Allah. The word hidayah and hadiyah come from the same word. And that this gift should be so valued to the hearts of the Muslims that every day they ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to keep them on sirat al-mustaqim. Ihdina sirat al-mustaqim. Number two, the importance of the ummah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, the wihda of this ummah being one community. So we ask Allah, guide us to sirat al-mustaqim. Sirat al-mustaqim in rhetoric is called isti'ara or kinaya, which means Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, instead of saying ihdina ila al-islam or ihdina ila deen al-islam, guide us to the way of Islam, we said اِهْدِنَا صِرَاطَ الْمُسْتَقِيمِ, guide us to the straight way. Allah does this all the time in Quran. He describes Islam in tangible ways because we cannot see Islam. We cannot hold Islam. So out of His, subhanAllah, His mercy for us, He uses these expressions like ظُلُمَات and نُور, darkness and light, to describe falsehood and to describe Islam. So we say, اهدنا الصراط المستقيم. And then the rest of the surah teaches us that there are three types of people, as I mentioned earlier, that we could possibly be from. And these three types of people are judged so according to their relationship with إياك نعبدو وإياك نستعين. The first are those who know, understand, have sincerity, and practice. And these are the people of Sirat al-Mustaqim. The second are those who know and don't practice. This is Maghdubi alayhim. The third are those who don't know and try to practice. So the Muslim asks Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make him from those who know, who have sincerity, have a sound understanding, have a sound intention, and couple that with sincere practice. There's a difference between knowing and understanding. Understanding Islam. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, whoever Allah intends good for, you faqihu fi deen. Here, understanding means that we engage Islam in a different way, a higher way, a greater way, that we take time to invest in thinking about our religion. Secondly, we couple that with the qualities of sincerity and love of Allah and kindness to others and benevolence to creation. And thirdly, we worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the way that He ordered us to do so. All of this makes the people, or makes us, insha'Allah, all of this makes us, insha'Allah, from Ahli Sirat al-Mustaqim, from the people of Sirat al-Mustaqim, who one great scholar said are the Ahl, are the people of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The way to achieve this is to continue to study the Qur'an. The Qur'an is an explanation of who is on Sirat al-Mustaqim and who is not. So I encourage you to continue to watch each of our episodes, to spend time with us reflecting on the Qur'an, so that we can all become from the people of Sirat al-Mustaqim, not al-Maghdubi alayhim, wa not al-Dhalin. Thank you for watching. Thank you for staying tuned to our important program. Thank you for watching our important program. We're very happy to have you with us. Stay tuned next time for Reflections. I'm your host, Imam Suhaib Webb. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.